All right, this is where we have our Star Trek news and Star Trek related news, and we start with some sad news. Our condolences to the family and friends of producer Manny Coto, who passed away after a 13-month battle with pancreatic cancer. Coto was executive producer of the fourth season of Enterprise, and he had some interesting plans for season five. We talked about it way back on Deep Space Minds a long while ago. He went on to produce other shows, including 24, for which he won an Emmy, Dexter, American Horror Story, so many more, most notably the horror film Dr. Giggles is in his resume. It's a cult classic nowadays. He passed away with loved ones around him. He survived by his wife, their four children, his mother, a sister, a brother, and eight nieces and nephews. He was 62 years old, and he will be missed. Strange New Worlds has hit the top 10. Nielsen putting out the streaming charts for the week of June 12th, and the season 2 premiere lands at number 7. This is the first time the show has charted, and it's the first Paramount Plus original series to hit that list since May. And we've got Emmy nominations out for Picard, picking up 2. Outstanding Contemporary Makeup and Outstanding Prosthetic Makeup nods for the show. The award ceremony will are live Monday, September 18th. And TrekCore reports that they have confirmed that Star Trek Picard, the art and making of the series by Joe Fordham, has been delayed. Titan Books will release the book now on December 12th instead of the original September date. And coming to a San Diego Comic-Con, Titan will have the next two hardcovers at their booth. Let me pull this one up here. Star Trek II, The Wrath of Khan, The Making of the Classic Film by John and Maria Tenuto. It's an in-depth look at the making of the movie featuring previously unseen production art, new interviews. This hardcover will run $50. And then we have Star Trek, The Art of Neville Page, by Joe Nazzaro, taking a look at Page's production design work for various Trek projects, starting with Kelvin Trek in 2009. It includes concept art, detailed sketches, insight into Page's creative process. This hardcover will go for $40. Next up from Rocklove Jewelry, these are officially licensed. We've talked about some of this before. This is a new ring featuring a yellow crystal offset in a Trek Delta nickel-free sterling silver, a cubic zirconia there, handcrafted. The listing on the website acknowledges gold as the colors worn by the command track officers, as it should be. This will knock you back $85. And if you want to put a bear in a uniform, Build-A-Bear has three options here. The Nebula Bear and the Tribble Gift Set. There's the Nebula Bear, the Tribble Gift Set, and the Red Uniform Gift Set. Now, these uniforms are also sold separately, as is the Tribble. So basically, you can get the Nebula Bear, and then you can get all the other uniforms if you want. The Bear by itself will run $29, Tribble Set $76.50, and the Red Uniform Set $66. These are available only on the Build-A-Bear website, not in a store yet. Here's the one from XO6. Lieutenant Commander Data, standard version, $230 plus shipping. Fully articulated, posable, about 12 inches tall, 30 points of articulation, as most of these figures have. Multiple hand options, two portraits to choose from. Comes with a tricorder, a pad, a Type 2 phaser, and most importantly, Spot. Pre-orders close July 26, so you have until then. Estimated delivery date sometime in the fourth quarter of this year. Trek model builder Bill Krause took to Twitter earlier this week to share that he had been in contact with Polar Lights from Round 2 while he was at Wonderfest, and at present, there's no plan to produce a model kit of the Enterprise G, formerly known as the Titan. Krause also notes, it seems there's more interest in finished replicas over model kits that you build yourself. We'll have a follow-up story there on that in just a second. Now, In a follow-up email, Round 2 senior designer James Hood tells a fan who shared this down thread that new product announcements happen when a given kit reaches certain benchmarks, and they have seen the interest in an Enterprise G kit. It will get due consideration in the future. So it sounds like they're at least talking about it. All is not lost, I guess. Maybe interest will be higher if we ever get a Star Trek Legacy television series, which also has not been announced yet. Meantime, Krauss occasionally will build some of these from scratch, but he's currently closed for commissions. Now, we mentioned the finished kits. Factory Entertainment is going to be getting into the replica model game with a new line of starships that are licensed through Paramount Consumer Products. FE Masterworks is the name of the new line. It'll launch at San Diego Comic-Con later this month. The first ships, we've got the Refit Enterprise here. We have the Excelsior. We have the Enterprise D, and then a fourth ship will debut later this summer. Now, we are seeing reports that these will go for about $15,000. I cannot confirm that, but that's what I've heard. Probably going to limit you to five. I don't know. Do you want to spend $15,000 on one of those? I don't. I can think of a lot of other things that I can do with $15,000. By the way, if anybody wants to send me $15,000, we can talk. Here's a little bit of fun from Terry Metalis. We talk about Atari cartridges. Terry shared this mock-up of a Star Trek Legacy video game for the Atari 2600 created by Ryan Kuckelman over at Second Meal Pizza Club. He's going to be making a limited run of these for you to actually buy these physical cartridges with that artwork. It includes a custom-made box for the game as well. He's going to make 50 of these. The first 15 are available to order now. They're $100 a piece over on Etsy. Personally, I'm curious about what actual Atari cartridges he's reusing with that artwork and if they're playable or not. That could be a fun surprise. You never know what you're going to get, right? Add a note from the website TrekZone. If anybody is following them, they have made the announcement that they will no longer be covering fan films. Now, this comes after recent shenanigans in the fan film community, where certain individuals and groups allegedly tried to influence their process for their latest fan film awards. And they said that, along with other drama in the fan film groups, TrekZone says they will no longer cover Trek fan films, which is fine, their choice, their rules. One quibble that I would note that in the headline for this editorial where they make that announcement, notably absent is the word alleged. You need to be careful about such things, guys. Just say it. And finally, now you can make coast-to-coast treks. A trek, as it were. Now you've got the studio tour in Ticonderoga, New York. Now in North Bend, Oregon, you can check out the Star Trek-themed room available at the Itty Bitty Inn. It's a retro geek chic motel on Route 101. Room number 3 has been decked out in Trek. Phase 1 is complete. Next comes the fully interactive stage props, so you can actually feel more like you're on a starship. And you can have some Tranya while Ensign Rizzo brings you extra towels. We'll have a link so you can check that out. And that is all that we have for the Star Trek notes for the week. We will be back to do this all again next week, so make sure that you're subscribed, have your notifications on, and we'll be back with more Star Trek news as things develop.
Copyright 2023 by Flaming Dog Media, LLC. All rights reserved. No portion of this program may be retransmitted without the express written consent of Flaming Dog Media. You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV, delivering the multiverse since 2009.